host of the Veronica Harris Show, and I'm here with my co-host.
Gregory Harris, co-hosting with you today.
You nothing else? You only co-host?
I'm just co-hosting
today. You just co-hosting that. Well, I have some excellent guests here. If you notice, I have four young gentlemen here, and these guys are the winning national champions, record-breaking, the second fastest time in prep history, running a quartet from T.C. Williams. And immediately to my, what was my left?
Yeah,
to my left, we have Noah Lyles, Kai Cole, then we have Josephus Lyles and Trekell Lockett. Now, let me tell you a little bit about Kai and Trekell. Well, Kai Cole is a 10th grade, his second year running, and already you're on a record-breaking relay team. Go you! Okay, they call you the puppy. We won't ask why. But you love photography. And now we have, at the end, we have Trekell Lockett, a 12th grader, relocated from North Carolina last year. You qualified for indoor nationals in the 60 meters in 2015. He ran on the pin relay winning 4x100 meter team in 2015, winning a watch, because everybody knows the pin relays, you can't buy them, you have to win it if you want to be part of the club, okay? And then you also qualified for the Virginia State 6A Championships in the 300 meters, which is an indoor meet in 2016. So that would be this year, correct?
Yes.
All right, awesome. And then, of course, we have, as we said, we have Noah Lyles. Okay. Noah Lyles here. Let me tell you a little bit about Mr. Lyles. Well, we have two, but let me tell you about Noah Lyles. Also, a 12th grader, broke the national record in the indoor 200 meters. National champ. Actually, you broke your record from, you won the last year.
Yep.
And you broke a record then last year, too.
Yep.
Okay, so you, okay, record breaking 2 years in a row. National champion 200 meters indoor 2016, 2015. National champion 100 meters. Junior Pan Am gold medalist 200 meters, junior Pan Am silver medalist in 100 meters, has competed for the U.S. in Cuba, China, Ukraine, and Canada. Also on the cover of Track and Field News. Did I get it all right?
I think that's all right.
Okay, and then let's talk about your brother Josephus, ever the modest one, not. 12th grader, national champion in the 60 meters, 2016, national champion in the 400 meters, 2015. National champion in the 400 meters 2014, silver medalist in the 400 meters World Youth Championships, bronze medalist in the 200 meters World Youth Championships, has competed for the U.S. in Cali, Colombia, also competed in Cuba and the World Junior Championships in Oregon. Did I get that all right?
I think so.
Okay. And what's awesome about the two of you also, besides being on the relay team, you guys are siblings, just like Gregory and I are siblings. But one of you is trying out for the World Junior. Who's trying out for the Junior World?
Oh, both of us.
Yeah. Okay, you're both trying out for that. But more importantly, you are also Olympic hopefuls for 2016. Yeah. Yes, awesome. But we do want to talk about this awesome relay team that you have here.
Hold on, Ron. Wait a minute. We didn't let them say anything.
Well, cause I'm not finished.
All right, but in three words, we're going to start on this end. In three words, tell us about yourself.
Hold on.
Go.
Wait. Hold on. No, G-Store, stop. Flag on the field. Who the host? Me.
Who's the co-host? Me. So let's continue.
Work hard at practice.
That's three words right there. Right. We're gonna take out the at.
All right. Don't cut them off.
That's in three words.
That's three words.
Okay, fine. I'm trying to be nice.
That's a little pushy.
Josephus Samuel Lyles.
Okay.
It was the name. Okay.
Two-turn Kai.
Creative, fast, amazing.
Amazing. All right, anything else you want to add before
We can go now.
Okay,
thank you. Let him say something. You did all the talking.
Well, I am the host.
We're out of breath and everything.
Anyway, so let's talk about this relay team. Let's talk about this 4x200 that you just recently broke the U.S. indoor national record. Okay, and that's the second fastest time in prep history, correct?
Yeah.
All right. So who was leadoff?
Me.
Who was second?
That's me.
Who was third? the all-important leg, third leg, yes. And who was Anka?
You know I had to bring it home.
You had to bring it home. Okay. So why don't you take us, don't you tell us a little bit about that race? Like, how did you feel? Like, were you nervous? How was it?
When I got on the track, I was just like, oh, man, it's time for my, it's my turn to run. Got on the track. I hear everybody screaming and stuff. Took a deep breath, got in the blocks, got out good. Then I saw that I was coming on to the guy in front of me, so I was just pushing, gave it to Noah, and it was just
gold. Okay, well, Noah, take it from there. What happened?
Well, you know, I saw my first leg, Trekell, give it to me at first, and it was, like, super cool because the guy who was in front of him was also on the team with Josephus of the World Youth in Cali, Colombia. Mm-hmm. So I was just like, oh, we getting it. Grabbed that baton, and I just gone, you know. I was just running as fast as I can. I was, like, I was loose. I was ready. I was giving everything I had. There was no holding back because we was going for this record. So okay. I was just coming in. I was just saw my puppy over here, Kai Cole, coming in hot, and I just wanted to yell, go, Kai!
And next, Kai, take it away from you.
Just so much energy. Like, all I know is if Noah comes in, isn't got in first, I have to stay there. So, just so much adrenaline. Everybody screaming. First time in history ever heard my name on a big screen. just if I lose the lead or if I fall, it's all on me. So I was just like, I gotta give it to Josephus. I have to. And like, hand it to Josephus, it was over.
Josephus, take us home.
All right, you know, I saw all my boys doing work, you know, my squad. They put in, you know, all that hard blood, sweat, well, not really blood and tears. You know, we've been practicing for it. We've been putting in the work at, and you know, in practice, you know, leading up to this. And, you know, even the prelims, we broke the national meet record in the prelims. Mm-hmm. So, you know, we were really going for that fastest ever in mm-hmm. the finals. And, you know, we were really close. I know we were definitely in contention for it when I got the baton. And, you know, I touched that baton. And I was a little tired before the race. I was a little yawning, you know, mm-hmm. a little tired. But, you know, I knew I had to step up when I got the baton. And I just knew that, you know, is all counting on me. So I was like, all right, Joe, you gotta go. So, you know, I'm just working the turn, just getting it, just working. And, you know, I'm coming closer to the line, and I'm just like I'm trying not to look at the screen because I know it's gonna slow me down. I'm just getting closer. I'm like, dang, I wonder how close we are. And I cross the line, and I look up, and it says 126.2. And the record was like 126, like 10. And I'm just like, no. Like, I could just, like, I felt my heart sink. But at the same time, I just felt so good because that was, mm-hmm. you know, the number two time in history. You know, we were the closest team to get to the national record. And, mm-hmm. you know, we were right there. And I know that, you know, my team, my squad gave everything. So, you know, just to be there and know that they gave everything, I gave everything. You know, we did our best. It was, and you know, to get the national championship,
yes.
and have the meet record.
That was awesome. So is that? I know you guys have a couple of national championships in under your belt but for you guys, Trekell and Kai, was this your first?
Yes, my very first.
Your first? Oh well, wow! What a great time to get it. So you know what? We're going to take a break right now, and actually, we're going to see the race on the video. We have the video. Your mother was nice to show it, bring it to us. So I'm going to show our viewers the video so they'll be able to actually experience what you guys just told us about. And then when we'll come back, we'll talk some more to you guys, Trekell and Kai. Find out what's this like running with these two guys. Okay. Find out what. And Gregory, you'll have a chance to add anything you want to add into it. But anyway, we're going to take a break. And when we come back, we'll have more of Trekell, Josephus, Kai, and Noah, the T.C. Williams 4x200 national record-setting team.
They said I have troll teeth.
That my voice sounded like a possessed baby doll.
That no one would ever love someone as stupid as me.
That I was fat, ugly.
Disgusting.
The effect of bullying is potent.
We will no longer be the silent majority.
Now, when you see online bullying, there's something you can do about it.
We're gonna take action with the eye.
I am a witness.
I am a witness.
I am a witness.
I am a witness.
I am a witness, and so are you.
We taught him how to hit a baseball.
how to hit a receiver. The strike zone. The net. You taught him how to hit the upper corner. You even taught him how to hit the open man. But how much time have you spent teaching him what not to hit?
Morning, Gary. We are GetSchooled.com. You want a college education, don't you?
You know you do.
That's why we're here. We're free and here to guide you through every step of the way, starting with attendance. Gary, financial aid forms. Picking a college, man. You and us go together like tacos and Tuesday.
And I love tacos.
Go to GetSchooled.com.
Here we go, boys, 4x200-meter relay championship final. Western Branch on the outside moving well, as is our new meet record holders, T.C. Williams in 5. Akaya Harris of Western Branch, Trekell Lockett of T.C. Williams. Noah Lyles, U.S. leader at 200 and 300 with the baton into the lead now for T.C. Williams. Lyles, smooth handoff to Kai Cole. 126.09 is the national record. We know it's on their minds, but put it on our minds as well. Western Branch running extremely well in second place. Josephus Noah with the stick. For Western Branch, it's Tristan Bird. Newberg, you lead in third. Here comes T.C. Williams. Someone else, and we all thought you loved yourself, but that couldn't have been the issue. Or maybe they just figured that now because they miss you. Maybe they wait for that official time. 126.21, lowering their own meet record and making their number 2 all-time time even better. T.C. Williams, your champion.
Hi, and we're back, and we've just seen that video of that awesome and exciting 4x200-meter indoor race at the New Balance Nationals that you guys won. How awesome was that? So now we want to talk about what are you guys doing moving forward. So, Joe, let's start with Trekell and Kai. Trekell, what are your plans when you finish at T.C. Williams, when you graduate? Because you are a senior, mm-hmm. correct?
Yes, ma'am. I'm going to go into the military, and then after that, I plan on going to college.
Okay, what branch in the military?
Army.
Okay. Oh, my sister's in the Army. Okay, very good. What made you decide to go into the Army first as opposed, and you know you can run in the Army too.
Yes, ma'am.
What made you decide to want to go into the military first before going to pursue your higher education?
Oh, my brother's in the military. He's in service. So mm-hmm. I was just thinking like.
So you're following your brother?
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, that's nice. And well, Kai, you got 2 more years at TCU. So what you going to do when these guys are gone? You going to carry on the tradition?
Yes, I have to.
Okay, and what is your main event?
My main event is like the short distance one, like mm-hmm. the 100, 55, 200, mm-hmm. if I'm in the mood.
Yeah. Okay. So we like to talk about, I know, like I ran track and I did relays. And relays is about chemistry because that's the one thing, it's an individual sport, but that's where it becomes a team sport. And relays are very important, like that stick work. You know, track athletes, we have trust issues. Because you drop that stick, it's like, because that race is over. Yeah. Race is over, especially if you're not one of those, chances where, like, I've seen it where the stick will drop and it'll bounce back up and somebody can pick it up and still keep running. But very seldom, once that stick goes down, your race is over and you know, not too many of us are as blazing fast as you guys that can, like, make up any type of deficit to put us back, to put a person back in contention. So, like, how long have you guys been together as a relay team?
Honestly, this year.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah,
It's funny because last year we had Kelvin and Kai, two sophomores.
Mm-hmm.
And Kelvin's also on the team. And he, you know, he's actually he's very talented also.
Mm-hmm.
He's more of a 400 runner, but we had two sophomores, Kelvin and Kai. And, you know, we'd be telling them, like, they were freshmen, and we were like, hey, you guys are, like, the next thing up. Like, you guys have this talent. You got to come to practice. You got to put in all this work and everything. And we were telling them that while, you know, we were doing our thing last year, because last year we had some pretty good relays as well.
Mm-hmm.
So this year, you know, it came time for them to step up. You know, honestly, we didn't even expect it as much, like, because we have a good amount of guys on the team that are pretty talented.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, Kai really stepped up, and he was, you know, he showed that he wanted it, and he put in the work, and, you know, he showed that, like, he deserves to be on that leg on the relay.
Yeah, I would imagine, because you running with some pretty, like, you know, my daddy always just said, you know, you weren't going to stomp him with the big dogs, you know. You had to run pretty fast, and you are short of stature. They call you puppy. I don't know why, but I mean, obviously they say it's not the fighting the dog, but the dog in the fight type of thing.
Something like that.
But what was it that in you that made you say, hey, I'm going to be with these guys? You know, I'm just as good, if not better. Okay, so I'm going to be on this team.
I just got tired of running with people in my grade. Like, it's just boring. Like, practice, like, last year when I first started, they would do individual races, like, individual practices, and then, like, I'll be with the JV runners and stuff, and it's, like, it just got boring. So I was just, like, I have to earn my way up to varsity with them, because I really love track, and then I don't want to run with them. Like, I want to go to places where I can get my name out there and stuff.
So that's what made you do it. Okay, so you had that competitive fire. All right, and Trey, you relocate. So you coming from another state, you know, you sort of had the new kid on the block, had to fit in. How did you manage to gel? Because, again, chemistry is so important. You know, we track people. We got trust issues.
When I came up here, I already knew, like, I had to work hard. I had to, like, gain their trust and show heart. And I showed it at Penn, and I guess I was just on the relay team.
It
just
happened. I mean, come on.
Yeah, well, I ran a good leg.
Okay. But you're only as good as your last race, so, I mean.
Oh, yeah.
Trey gives heart. He has heart. Every time Trey gets on the track, you know, he gives everything.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. He's always going to be that person that if he doesn't give you the stick in first, you know that he tried his hardest. Like,
mm-hmm.
like he will put pretty much everything on the track for his team. And, you know, even from the first race when we ran with him, we saw that, you know, he runs until he just can't run anymore. So,
are you the spokesperson?
you know, I
switch spokespersons.
I'm not the designated team leader, but I'm pretty much the team leader, I like to think.
I like to think until someone gets in trouble. Then he blames me.
Okay, so he blames you. Then you take over. Why? Because you're the more.
I'll take over. He just tells them that I was in charge. But, you know, when something bad comes on, it's usually my job to fix it.
He's
the guy who motivates everybody, and I'm the guy who gets us on point.
Now, again, you two are siblings, but one of you is older than the other. So who is the oldest?
I'm the oldest.
Oh, so that's why when something happens, he says,
oh, yeah. Most definitely.
Okay. So, again, so Trekell, being the new person in charge, you just said, you just was like, I'm just going to show them that I belong.
Yeah.
Okay. Any other relays that you guys run together, or this is the only one that you guys all four are together on?
The 4x1, it's us four also. That's more of an outdoor thing, you know. Mm-hmm. We don't have 4x1s.
Now, that's lots of stick trust issues.
Almost definitely.
Yeah. Who's lead off on that?
It's the same order, actually.
Okay, it's the same order. So, again, third leg, very important. Third leg is always very important because, you know, that's where the people like to hide people. Okay, it's usually if they want the weak leg, they want to hide them on the third leg.
Oh, we're not so, hiding any weak legs.
No, I didn't think so.
We don't have any weak legs.
We don't got weak legs.
No, I didn't think so. So what are the prospects looking like for the 4x100 outdoors?
I don't know. I'm just, like, really nervous for this 4x100. Like, especially when we're going to in California, like, the way they're making it sound is like I'm really nervous.
We just make this sound like it's fun. I don't know what he's talking about.
We put meats on high pedestal because these are meats we're looking at on, like, we went to Milrose this year, and, like, that's a really big meat that me and Jesse has been watching for years, and now we're going to it, and we're going to Arcadia, and we're just, like, super hyped because we found all these fast times, and we're going up against good competition. So I can see that we sometimes kind of scare him a little, but we definitely have major trust in Kai. Every time we go to a meet, we're like, yo, we don't even need to worry about Kai because we know that he's just like Trey, just like all four of us. We're all going to give our all because we want to do well for our team. We want to do the best that we can. And when we all come together, we all make a great relay.
Now, you guys are into track and field. You watch it a lot. And I know you keep up with the history of track and field. And you see how, unfortunately, on the men's side, a lot of drop batons.
Yeah.
A lot of drop batons. So, and I know you guys obviously don't drop the baton too much. So what do you attribute, or how much stick work, or do you think stick work is important?
Insanely important. Last year, we didn't really do that much stick work, but we didn't focus on relays as much. This year, a lot of stick work, 2 to 3 times a week at least for baton passing, baton exchanges. You know, just last week alone, we did batons
every day
at least. Yeah, 3, if not every day, like 4 times last week.
And what happens if somebody drops a baton in practice?
They got to do push-ups.
Push-ups. 10 push-ups for a drop baton.
Who does the most push-ups?
Nobody.
Nobody.
We don't drop the baton.
Okay.
You only do 10 for?
Well, you know, it increases the more you do it. So, yeah. You know, 2 times is 20. You do it 3 times is 40.
Okay, but since y'all don't drop the baton.
We don't drop the baton.
Exactly. Okay, well, that's very good. But we're going to end by the ending soon. But before we do that, I definitely want to make sure, because, again, Josephus and Noah, you guys are Olympic hopefuls. And if people want to check you guys out, find out more information, to go support you guys, to see what's going on with you guys, you know, or just, like, see more races of you guys or all four of you guys, where can we go?
You can definitely go to my mom's Facebook at Keisha Kane, KEISHACAINE.
Okay, and they can get information, see pictures, see more great videos of you guys. Exactly. And you all have Twitter?
Yeah.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Trekell, what's your Twitter?
At Ordi, ORDIE, track.
Okay.
At quarter_horse22.
Okay.
At
puppy? No, I just playing.
At 2TURNTKAI.
Okay.
At Lyles Noah, LYLESNOAH.
And we also have Instagram?
Yep.
Yes, ma'am.
Instagram?
Nojo18, NOJO18.
Twofly.KAI.
Twofly,
JJAY_sprint.
The_sprint guy.
The Sprint God. Okay.
He's doing a little song.
All right. Okay. Well, thank you all for being on our show. We have enjoyed you all. Gregory, any last words?
I mean, we got to do another show because you ain't give me no time on this one.
Honestly.
No. Really? I had some good questions. It wasn't track related, but I wanted to get to hear about the young man and, you know, being young and black. And this time, you know, thinking back in 96 when I was young and black, and I wanted to see what they going through in 2016, but you ain't give me any time to do none of that, bro.
Oh, come on. Blame it all on me, huh? Yeah, all right. Well, anyway, well, thank you all for joining us and watching. And again, check these guys out. And if you had the pin relays, check them out there. If you are anything, you know, check these guys out. Go to Keisha Kane on the Facebook page so you can find out more about what they're doing. Hopefully you took down their Twitter and their Instagrams so you can find out what they're doing, because they'll be running at a place near you. So again, we want to thank our guests. Gregory, you think our guests?
Yeah, thanks, guys.
Thank you for coming. We've enjoyed you, and we'll see you all next time here, and thank you guys for watching.